What's up, boys? Welcome back to the channel. Welcome to another awesome video. I am not Eight Thoughts. I'm glad you're all here. If you're new here, be quick with it and subscribe. It's free. And that is your mom texting me right now to let me know that you haven't subscribed. And if you don't subscribe, you ain't getting no dinner. So subscribe. With that being said, let's rock and roll into this video. It's pretty obvious to anyone who's got an IQ above 30 that Sledgehammer Games doesn't know in a high five and fuck what they're doing. Vanguard is completely busted and broken, and it looks like it has never been game tested. There are so many glitches, so many broken functions, so many broken, I don't know what would you call it, just stuff. They got broken grenades and map glitches and gun problems and unlocking camos isn't working properly and looty lotty booty da, etc., etc., onward and onward. There's more problems with Vanguard than wait on Wings of Redemption. I can't help myself.
Hey, whatever. I hope your family dies in an automobile wreck.
And Sledgehammer Games, instead of fixing all these problems, decides to go on vacation not once, but twice in the matter of the last few weeks. And I understand it's Christmas holidays and whatnot, blah, blah, blah. But when you are in charge of releasing a game and you provide a product that is completely broken, and then you update the game, and then you break previous Call of Duty titles, rather, on top of that. So if you don't know, the recent updates to Vanguard that Sledgehammer Games did before they went on break for the second time actually broke Modern Warfare 2019 and kind of messed up Cold War a little bit, but has made Modern Warfare 2019 completely unplayable, like broken. But yet that game is still being sold, and a lot of people got that game for Christmas. A lot of people buy that game because it's on sale, because they heard Vanguard sucks so much. So how do you sell a broken product at full price, or even a discounted price, or even sell it at all, knowing that there's broken, you know, issues with the game that make it almost unplayable? Not almost, actually entirely unplayable. It turns off your console, it freezes, etc., etc. And then on top of that, the game Call of Duty Vanguard, which is completely busted and broken at the same time from the updates, they just decide we're going to go on vacation. And this is not new. Like, there's a history and a pattern here of Sledgehammer Games being crap, and they are getting fired, as the title of this video says. They're going to get the boot, 100%. They already got fired once. They're given a little bit of a second chance now for this game, and they completely broke it, completely busted it. Call of Duty Vanguard is the worst selling Call of Duty since Call of Duty 4. And Activision notices that. And Activision wants their money. And if you aren't providing a service to make Activision money, Activision has to do everything in their power, by law, to make money for their shareholders. And Sledgehammer Games is breaking that law because they're doing a shitty job, and they decide we're going to go on vacation because they know they're getting fired anyway. So like, yeah, cool, we don't really care about fixing this game, we don't like you, Activision, we don't really think you're treating your employees properly, you're going to fire us anyway, so you know what, we're not going to do a whole lot to fix this game. It's rather obvious what's going on. But Sledgehammer Games has already been fired before, and like I said, they were given this second chance, which they have blown, so they're definitely getting the boot, which is good and bad. Now, what happened back in 2020? It was supposed to be Sledgehammer's turn to make the game. That's when we got Call of Duty Cold War. It was Sledgehammer's turn, but couldn't do what they're supposed to do. They made a horrible game. Things weren't going well. The people at Sledgehammer Games are a bunch of knobs and don't get along with people, apparently. And they got fired. And Treyarch had to come in and make Call of Duty Cold War, which is why Call of Duty Cold War is also not very good, because we're on a 3-year game cycle. So Treyarch had to make the game back to back because they made Black Ops Cold War, or Black Ops rather, 4. It's hard to keep track. I'm sorry. It's hard to keep track because when you get so much shit, it all just sort of looks the same and blends together, and he's got a big shit sandwich, and then the shit hawks come down, and then Leahy gets drunk and then passes away because of alcoholism, and then Ricky comes walking around and just gets hit in the head with a flying hockey puck, and Bubbles like loses all his cats, and the damn shopping carts end up in the damn lake. If you know what I'm saying! I don't know how many of you got that reference, but if you got that reference, leave a comment down below. Let me know that you know what's up. Okay, let's get it back on track here. So, in 2020, Sledgehammer Games already got kicked off of the Call of Duty they were supposed to be making because they don't know what the fuck doing. And now we got Call of Duty Vanguard, and it's obvious they still don't know what the hell they're doing. They may have, like, you know, a solid foundation. Like, I mean, keep it real with you. Call of Duty Vanguard could be a very good game. Like, it really could be a good game. It has a lot of potential. The gunplay itself and the maps, for the most part, to me, a lot of you may disagree. A lot of you haven't even played the game. You played the beta. And if you've only played the beta and you're making a decision on this game from playing the beta, then it's not going to be a very well-informed decision. The beta compared to the full release game, even though the full release game is it's a gong show, is a million times better than the beta. However, I digress. Call of Duty Vanguard, without all the issues and all the problems, to me, is a lot of fun. And most people who play the game will say it has a lot of potential, a lot of fun. But Sledgehammer Games obviously doesn't have the skills required to finish the game and actually produce a functioning game. But lo and behold, the game is busted. And Sledgehammer Games is on vacation twice, and they've fixed the game by making it worse and destroying previous titles. So, woo, congratulations. Without a doubt, Sledgehammer Games can get fired. And to get back to that original point again, that's not a good thing. Being fired is not a good thing. It's good because they don't know what they're doing. But overall for Call of Duty, losing a development team is going to make Call of Duty worse. And in fact, this may be the beginning of the end of Call of Duty, or they're going to have to, there's going to be drastic changes, I imagine. There's going to have to be, or Call of Duty is just going to keep spiraling down and down and down, and eventually it's just going to become Halo, until maybe they can be rectified like Halo did this year with Halo Infinite. Right now, they're on a three-year cycle. We got Treyarch, Infinity Ward, and Sledgehammer Games, and they each get a year, you know, to put out their game, and then it comes around every 3 years. And as that stands right now, they can't actually make the game in 3 years and be complete without releasing it with all these bugs and all these issues and just a mess, really. And then 6 months after it being released, they finally get around to having it being a good game. And then, of course, a new game, and the cycle continues and repeats. So if you take a developer out of that cycle, you crunch down the time even further, giving him even less time to make the game. Consequentially, ergo, making the game even worse, causing even more problems, leading to less time, less development, which will equate to more bugs and more issues. Because if you have less time, it ain't going to work out if you couldn't do it with more time. If you know what I'm saying, maybe Raven will be that third developer. Maybe Raven Software will come in and form with a different developer. I don't know how they're going to do it, but there's going to be definitely a big mix-up after this year. Sledgehammer Games is not going to be involved at all. Sledgehammer Games is getting fired. They're going to have to come to some kind of different development cycle, a different team working on the game, or they're not going to do any of that, which I don't foresee it happening, because Activision, like I said, wants to make money. They have to make money. They just had their worst Call of Duty ever. Next year, Infinity Ward is making Modern Warfare 2, whatever. I don't know how they keep track of these names. It was Modern Warfare 2019. Now we got Modern Warfare 2 2022. So next year will be fine, because it hasn't had a chance to catch up to development problems. And then Treyarch will be the next year, which will be kind of rough, because they had to make Call of Duty 2020, which wasn't supposed to be their year. So they've had to make kind of like three games within 3 years almost. So that game might be kind of messed up. I don't know, man. All I know is that this Call of Duty Vanguard and Call of Duty in general and first-person shooters in general are just in a shitstorm right now. And it's quite frankly, it's just a hot mess going around. And then quite frankly, it's unfortunate it's come to this, but all good things must come to an end, just like this video must come to an end. And I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you very much. Love you guys. Appreciate all the support as always. Have yourself a great day. If you're new, once again, make sure to subscribe, or your mom ain't going to make dinner for you. And I'll see you guys on the next video real soon. All right. Peace out. Thank you.